if female leadership actually worked, look at the African American community, for example, we'd be in a lot better shape. We've seen 70% illegitimacy, meaning that you have broken homes where the female is leading the family. And we find that it leads to high incarceration rates, high instances of poverty, low educational attainment. Those are clearly situations where we're not winning. Further, if we're looking at women in general, because I'm not throwing African-American women under the bus, I love them. If we're looking at women in general, are women meant to lead? Nah, not really. All of the science even says this is not the case. If you look at the data in entrepreneurship, which is an activity that requires risk, it requires a tolerance for the unknown. Women don't embrace risk for the most part. There are a couple, those are called outliers. So all the data shows that women are inclined to want someone to take care of them, right? That's why you might hear some of them looking for a provider or a sugar daddy. Right? They want to take that easier position to where they don't have to be out on the front lines all the time. Further, if you look at work hours, even in competitive fields like medicine among female doctors versus male doctors are inclined to work longer hours, more overtime. Why? Because it's the male nature. Women at some level don't want to work themselves to death. And we observe that they like to be pampered. Hell, they want to take some time out, go to the spa, get their nails done, do all these other things that are not work oriented. It's actually quite the opposite. It's a leisure oriented.